We're here today with Pamela Lindell, who is running for Royal Oak City Commissioner. How are you today?
Fantastic. How are you?
Great. Thank you so much for coming. Can you tell us why you've decided to run for this position?
I'm very passionate about Royal Oak. I love Royal Oak. I love my home, my neighbors. I've been involved in the city since day one, and I want to be proactive for the citizens and for my fellow neighbors.
So can you tell me some of the ways that you've been involved in the community?
I am a Friends of the Royal Oak Library board member. I've done that for 20 some years. We're the worker bees. We raise all the funds that pay for all the programming at the library. I volunteer at the shelter. When my son was in school, I did latchkey, helped out any way at school I possibly could. So I've just been involved in the area.
You know, are there any particular issues that are important to you?
Yes, our families and our residents. It seems like the current administration is concentrating a lot on the 9 square blocks of downtown Royal Oak. And what I'm finding when I talk to the residents, we have young families who moved to the area because they loved Royal Oak, everything it had to offer, and they've watched it change so drastically in the last few years that they're not comfortable going down for family adventures downtown Royal Oak, and that's not good.
What would you do to focus more on the neighborhoods and the families?
Well, by talking to them, we're finding out what they need and what they want. They're concerned about our library. Our library, we had a millage years ago, and we're due for another one. So we have to get another millage to perk up our library. And when we get that millage, in the past, we had a public safety millage. And that public safety millage passed, and then the money that was designated for public safety in the budget went out, and we only used the new money coming in from these millages. And I don't want to see that happen with the library. The library needs all the money that we have. We have to use the money that's designated for the library as well as any millages we pass going forward.
Can you tell us some of your professional experience?
I've been a volunteer and activist in Royal Oak for almost 30 years. My husband and I made a conscious decision that I would stay home with our son and raise our son and do that. So I have been, that's what allowed me to become so involved in the community and in the city and to be a part of what's happening and have my finger on the pulse of our wonderful Royal Oak.
Are there any skills that you learned as being a parent that you think would be helpful to you if you're elected?
Well, yes, absolutely as a parent, but more so as the running the household. You know, my husband, he was very confident in me, so he handed me everything, and I took care of all our finances and all our bills, and I'm very frugal, and we never had to rob Peter to pay Paul, never were in collections, never bankruptcy, all these things that you hear about happening to people. I run a tight ship. We are very fortunate. It was difficult because we were on such a fixed income, but I think we did rather well for ourselves considering.
Now, in this race, there are a few people running for these seats. Why should the voters pick you?
I'm not a politician. I'm grassroots. I'm your neighbor. I'm not being backed by anybody. Nobody gave me permission to run. Nobody gave me their seal of approval. I didn't ask for anything. I'm not getting any money from anybody. I'm strictly for the people. So if you're happy with what's going on downtown, that's fine. But if you would like to see something fresh, some changes, somebody be proactive for the residents, for the seniors, for the new families moving in, as we move forward, I'm your girl.
So if the voters want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
They can go to my website, lindellfororoyaloak.com, www.lindellfororoyaloak.com. Yes, and you can, from there, it'll lead you to my Facebook page and my email, and please contact me with your concerns and your questions and anything you think we need to talk about or get done moving forward, please.
Great. Well, thank you so much for coming out today.
Thanks for having me.